Hi folks, today we are going to talk about Android data storage, and in particular we are going to talk about shared preferences. So different data storage options are available in Android device. This is a list of them. As I mentioned, one of them is shared preferences, internal storage, external storage, SQLite database, network storage, and cloud storage. So today we will talk about using shared preferences. So this method of storage using single primitive data in name value pairs, and these are preferences using for the application as one default file in this case. Shared preferences, this is probably the simplest way to store the data in Android. You do not worry about creating the file using file's application interface. It stores data in XML file. So in shared preferences basically support the following types: Boolean, float, integer, longs, and strings. Let's build a basic application using shared preferences. So the tutorial will be looks like this. It will be expecting from you to enter name and for example the age. So if you enter name in the first field, for example Alex, and age, for example 25, and save information. So next time when you exit application and run again, the application will be saved. So if you reset information and exit application again and run it again, you see the information is preserved between sessions. Let's get started.
You have to wait when Gradle finishes to build the basic Android Hello World project, and we will start modification soon. So I will switch to Activity Main XML. This is we currently have Hello World. Of course, I will delete Hello World. And right now I will change default relative layout to linear. And erase this padding block and add here Android orientation vertical. So I want right now to drag and drop edit text. So first of all, I would like to bring plain edit text for me, and then I want another edit text for number. All right, so for the name I will be using ID edit text name. For age, I will be using number sign. I can write here hint. What is hint? Hint is something when the field is displayed to give kind of like a prompt for the user. So maybe we can have a hint for name as well. So that will be identical structure for both fields. For the age, I want to have also new ID, and I just type here edit text age. That will be more comfortable for me. Then I need two buttons. I need one button save. This button has a name save, and another button will be reset, since I need to reset it. And yeah, so looks like we can make a one margin here to make it a little bit distance between this. So I'm going to text representation. I will put here Android layout margin top. Let's make a dimension of activity vertical margin. So in this case, you see a little bit space here between those. Actually, we can do the same for the all elements. We can do the same here. Android layout margin top vertical margin, and the same here. Android layout margin top vertical margin. So in this case, we have a little bit better design and more space. We can move to main activity. So we will declare edit text variable. name and age. This variable will be necessary to be accessed by different functions. And for example, I will write function private void init, and this function will be initializing those variables every time when I need them in the program. So how are we gonna use them? So we did it many times in our previous tutorials. I just only copy and paste. We initialize name as widgets find view by ID edit text name, and age is initialized by find view by ID at edit text age. And every time when we run the application, we have to call the init in this case. Now we're going to start saving data in file in shared preferences. So first of all, we have to declare shared preferences variable. And shared preferences variable will have the name myprefs. And the type of this variable shared preferences. Now we are moving to onCreate method and initialize myprefs variable. So we have to write myprefs get preferences, and we have to supply with a mode private. So let's comment on this. Because this retrieves the default shared preferences file that belongs to the activity, you do not need to supply a name for this file. The file will have the same name as the project name with XML extension. So it's pretty much straightforward, because we need only one file per this application, so we don't need to worry about how to name this file. So if you run application right now, you will see the basic design for preference tutorial. Of course, we can enter any information here, we can type any numbers here, but nothing happened when you press save or set, because we didn't create any button listeners. So let's create a button listener for save and reset. So switch to the activity main XML, press on save, go on click, and for example type here on save and press enter. The same for reset. Press on reset button, and on click property will type on reset and enter. So let's start with the first method implementation. So I like to switch to text view and then come into the button with on save. Wait here for a second, then go to this bubble, press on save. So method public void on save will be responsible for saving information in shared preferences file. So first of all, I will read information from a name field and save in the local variable name text. And then I retrieve information from age field and save in the local variable age text. I need to use shared preferences editor to save data to the file. And now is the most important moment. I have to save data in shared preferences using editor. So how to do it? Editor dot. So we have a very good set of functions starting with a put. And if you save in a string, I will use an put string. I have to create any key that I will remember for this piece of data. I will use key name, for example, for myself. And second variable will be the name text. So one more piece I have to save. It will be int variable. And in this case, I will use here, for example, key age. And the second piece of variable will be age text. So it's very similar how we say it before in save on instance in bundle. And finally, that we have to call commit
method. So commit method will save data in shared preferences file. So basically this is all procedure how to save data. So now we need to move to the second button in our layout. It will be onReset method. So click on this method and create onReset view in main activity. So what we will do here, we will call again shared preferences editor. I just copy this line. Second, I clear shared preferences by using editor.clear. And finally, I have to commit changes using editor.commit changes. In this case, reset will clear information. So how to load information that we saved? So we save information when we clear reset information. So we have to write a method to load information. So I write new method here, and in this method I will read the data from saved person and display into edit text. Public void read preferences. And in this method I have to read data from the saved person and display into edit text. So how to read from shared preferences? You have to use my preferences variable, and using get, for example, string will give you opportunity to read a string with the key. So what is the key for the string we need, we interested right now? So the key name and key age, right? So we're using key name for reading name, and the default either key name will be not found, it will be just blank. And the save in a local variable st1, for example. And after this we're going to update the field with the widget's name. And we will be setting text that accept actually one variable with a string st1. That should work for the string. For age, a little bit complicated because we need to do some conversion. So we find the key, H key in my prefs files and assign to value 1, and the age edit text will be set in with a set text of the value of val and converted to the string. So this is pretty much the method that will be responsible to read preferences. But we didn't call this method yet, so why we have to call this method? So probably we have to call this method once we finish initialization, and I would call this method right after initialization. Call this method here read preference. So right now we are running file, and we're going to check how it works. So let's try right now new name and new age and press save button. So exit application, run application again. This is my application. And you see for some reason like my name is preserved but age is not. So let's see why. Looks like I found error. I put wrong key here. This is always happen with me when I make a typo. So we have a kh key for the int variable, but I typed h key. So I have to type kh and try again. So I'm sorry for this, but that's actually the easiest error that I can have, right? Hopefully. So let's try again to type new name and type new age. This information. Run again, and we have a mark 30. It remained the same. Let's reset it And you see what is interesting, reset is not affecting immediately what we have right now, right? So probably when we reset information, we want also to read information. So let's call method read preferences after we clear information. Let's put here read preferences and run again. Let's type new piece of information, exit, run again, KT19, and reset. Yeah, so once we reset information right now, we see that the fields have been cleared. And yeah, that's pretty much what we have for this video. Thanks a lot.